2 hours ago, I was in central London. Now I'm in the capital of Wales. Cardiff is one of Britain's great cities with a remarkable repertoire of heritage, plus places to shop, sleep, and watch rugby, but not all at the same time. Intriguing, impressive, free. No, not me, National Museum Cardiff, whose dome is home to a mammoth collection ranging from ancient creatures to French Impressionists, including Renoir's Parisienne, Rodin's Kiss, and Monet's Water Lilies. Here at Cardiff Bay, a decrepit Dockland district has been transformed into a haven of excellence and entertainment, complete with Norwegian church, Welsh assembly, and about a million places to eat and drink. Just along the shore in Penarth, you can look across to the islands of the Bristol Channel, to the coast of Somerset and the newly restored pier, and then get a bit of lunch in my favourite destination restaurant here, the Fig Tree, where I think I'll have the fish. To find the great outdoors, just head north from the Great Western Railway line. 6 miles from Port Talbot Station takes you to the heart of Afan Forest Park, ideal for hiking or biking. At the end of the main line from London is Swansea, whose illustrious history as the economic powerhouse of Wales is evident in the handsome architecture. When I'm in town, I like to stay in Morgan's, the former Port Authority HQ, now converted to a boutique hotel. Swansea has an important place in railway history. It was the location for the world's very first fare-paying passenger railway service, which opened in 1807 from the city on this very route out to the village of Oystermouth, also known as Mumbles. The best place to appreciate Swansea Bay in all its glory is here at Mumbles Pier and Lighthouse Station. It's also a good place to begin a deeper exploration of South Wales, for instance, 12 beautiful miles west from here along the Gower Peninsula. I'll certainly be coming back to South Wales again soon, but as the day goes over the hill into the deep sea, as the local hero Dylan Thomas put it, it's time for me to head back to London at a very comfortable 2 miles a minute.